going to give me your shorts.
Wait, my what?
Your shorts.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Your shorts, sir.
Yeah, I thought you said something
else. No. That's not what I meant. That's not... Oh, no.
Hey, what's that?
All right.
God bless.
This is for you, darling.
First year short film. Thank you, Capital Cineforum. You always know what to get.
It was a regular Friday afternoon, past 5 o'clock, past the point of no return. Things are going slow in the office. Why do I talk like this? Anyway, 5 shots later, she came to my door.
Come in.
I told her to come in.
He told me to come in.
Is this CCF?
This is.
Then you know why I'm here.
I do.
I didn't.
I'm searching for shorts. I need shorts.
Damn those legs.
What?
What?
What do you say?
I have what you're looking for, Missy.
Oh my. Is that...
It is.
Where did you get it?
A UT student directed it. Marshall Douglas. This is Shadow at Lover's Peak. Enjoy.
Chet, do you remember what you said 2 weeks ago?
What did I say 2 weeks ago?
You said that if I came up here with you, that I'd be your girl. Oh, Chet, there are wolves out tonight.
Those don't exist, okay? What?
Did you see that?
There's nothing else out here.
It looked like a long dress or a ghost or something.
Those don't exist, okay?
But I saw something.
Hey, I'll protect you.
What was that? Did you do that?
No, it wasn't me. I'm scared.
Don't worry, okay? It's just a falling branch.
Let's get out of here.
Relax, why don't you? There's no one else out here.
And a good night to all you lovers out there in Sunny Crest. This song may sound like ancient history, but we know that you will all love it.
Something. I saw it.
It's just rabbits that like to startle people, okay? It'll be okay.
Chet, have you ever seen the woods when it's filled with snow? It's beautiful and gentle, and animals can disappear right into it if they hide their bodies right. It's just, I've never seen an animal disappear so fast.
Come on.
What was that?
I don't know, but I'm not staying to find out. Come on! Damn it!
What do we do?
Yes, okay. Don't get out of the car. Do you see anything?
No.
Turn the brights on. Get them on.
Semicircular cephalon, segmentothorax, trilobitoglycoid. But those went extinct since the Middle Cambrian era. 500 million years.
What?
Chet, get back in the car! Chet, the abdominal cavity hit the weak spot!
Huh?
There'll be more shorts after the break.
Hey, dude, I've had this on my mind. If God's omnipotent, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah.
He can do anything, he has the power.
Oh, sure.
Can he, like, per se, create a rock, like, huge rock, that's just too big for him to pick up? Think you could do that?
My name's Edward. I produce a little show for TSDV called Capital Cineforum. Nobody really knew about us last semester.
Thanks.
And to be honest, nobody really knows about us this semester either. The fact is, we here at Capital Cineforum have a lot to offer any television audience. It's good. We are student short films made by UT students. You know, movies like...
No!
Well, and our episodes have fun themes like...
Those films were out of sight.
But we have funny opening sketches, too. They tend to be about cat food commercials. It's just sort of a thing. Oh, thanks. So watch Capital Cineforum next semester. Really? Please?
Shh.
This is World Spicy.
Gabriel Gibaldi, and I'm sitting here with Jim Clark.
You got what you wanted. And what else do you want out of me? Oh, dollface. You're stabbing me in the back.
No, I'm not. If you want to get stabbed in the back, then get a load of this. Our next student short film is Salesman's Reprise.
Jeepers! That's an Ibit Brazil and Alison Hefner film starring Rory Harmon.
cynical.
Maybe you'll think of me when you are all alone. Maybe the one who is waiting for you will prove untrue, then what will you do? Maybe you'll sit and sigh, wishing that I were. Maybe you'll ask me to come back again, and maybe I'll say maybe. Maybe you.
Pull the trigger, honey. I dare you won't.
We'll be right back.
That was cold as ice. Water.
Oh my God! Oh. He's having a seizure! He's having a seizure! What do I do?
Me There's not too. Many girls on this show, so I'm
there
so
aren't.
Excited. I know!
There aren't.
Who is a... Who's a flamethrower?
I got a flamethrower. Oh, let's run down to the cafe and get a cherry Coke and some hamburgers.
Video Game Hour Live! Woo!
Sam, play them again.
This is a 10-second remix. Bam, bam!
Check, get back in the car!
No! No! Ah!
Sunny Crest?
wishing that I were near.
It's kind of dark in here. Turn on the lights, will you? No, no, wait! I like it in the dark, don't you see?
Baby, you're not making a whole lot of sense.
Well, let's see if these make sense. This is the experimental minute.
Thanks for watching, CCF.
Hope you had a swell time.
I think this is the start to a beautiful friendship.
Found my ball. Hi, I'm Wes, one of the producers of Video Game Hour Live. Here at Video Game Hour Live, we do a lot of crazy and wild things. Wild and crazy things that we can't show to you on our broadcasting. So, we decided to compile a nice blooper reel for all of you. Let's check it out.
Just keep going. It's not retarded here.
I'm a good coal miner, guys. I'm Matt Moreau. I'm a good coal miner.
And yay! Since we love playing games on the show, we have interesting news coming up with Aaron and Kevin, and we're gonna.
Would you just love that if I did a host segment that was just farts?
Welcome to Video Game Hour Live.
Oh. And we're. Okay, stop. Deep breath. Okay.
Hey, this is Joseph.
And I'm Leah.
And this is Industry News.
Yay!
That was terrible.
That's so awkward. Oh, okay, do that.
Da 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 da. Come here.
I just get video game F.
Tony, f*** you. F*** you, Tony. Hey, Tony, f*** you. F*** him. F*** him.
And something to stuff your thumb.
Start over. Just keep rolling. Let's just keep going.
Okay.
Okay, that's awesome.
Let's go to Assassin's Creed 2.
A guy who knows what to do.
Yeah, it's a trailer for Zelda Spirits Path. Path.
Spirit Track.
Spirit Track. And this is your dose of industry news. In the wake of Thanksgiving week and the ensuing shopping scramble, console sales have turned up mixed results. Sony is selling over 400,000 PS3s beat.
I don't know why I'm your friend.
I keep peeking.
Sure, I guess. I mean, they are losing us, you know, forever since we both have bigger troopers.
Rolling.
Merry Christmas, mother. What did I do that last? What did I do that?
That was Uncharted 2.
And do it again.
Miles can't speak.
Do it again.
I don't even know how I was connecting that.
I'm Kevin Riney.
And I'm Aaron Zeck. Back to you guys.
See you next year! Bitches!
What else are we gonna have?
Lots of gay sword jokes. So, how long is this supposed to be?
Let's do this.
Tony, you
Tony, everybody.
What about your night show? Get out of here.
Tony's a
You are pathetic. Truly and utterly just at the bottom of the barrel.
Damn it! Can't find my ball. Well, I hope you enjoyed those bloopers. I sure did. And if you did enjoy them, you know what you could do? You can check out Video Game Hour Live on TexasStudentTV.com. Or you can also watch us from 9 to 10 on TSTV. There's my There it is. Video Game City, what's that? No goose! No!
It's a Christmas miracle! Oh God, it's bullets!
Oh God! Oh my God! Ah! Oh my God, there's more dogs!
I haven't heard you make a funny joke all day.
I talked to five guys, and all five of them said, "What's up with video games?"
Welcome to TNN, where news so fair it's not even balanced. I'm Philip McCrevis.
And I'm Seamus McGee. Love is in the air at this time of year, and I have to say that it's sickening, because my on-call hoe is out of town on a blowjob, and so I'm not getting any tonight.
Well, Seamus, I'm sorry to hear about your love forecast, but I'd love to help you out, but weather's never really been my strong suit.
Well, now I know what's more important in your life. For our first story, we have something that'll cheer up all the single people in the world.
And something that I've dabbled with in the past, dominatrixes.
Would the plural be dominatrixi?
I think the plural will be four at a time.
Hello everyone, I'm Bobby Ricky here with a very special guest for TNN. The one and only, Fantasia Black Soul, Dominatrix Supreme.
Hello, weaklings.
So your premium escort service, Bruises and B***s, has seen quite a jump in business recently. What do you think has caused this burst of interest in dominatrix services?
First off, no more questions. I'll be in control of this interview.
But this is a very interesting...
No talking.
But...
Shut up.
What?
Do you want me to clip jumper cables to your nipples? Answer the question.
Yes?
That's what I thought. Now you may ask me your trivial questions.
What do you think has brought about your newly found success?
Well, no one likes to be lonely, whether it's a little b- like you or the elderly closeted door greeter at Walmart. No one wants to spend Valentine's Day alone. I offer high-quality beatings to those in need of punishment.
What sets you apart from your competitors?
I do not limit myself to conventional weapons of ass destruction like whips and chains.
Can you give some examples?
Shut the hell up and only speak when you're spoken to. You may speak now, you incompetent ass fiend.
Well, that isn't the first time I've been called that before. Alrighty then, so how can people...
Filthy demons.
Excuse me?
My clients are not people. They are filthy demons.
My apologies. How can filthy demons make an appointment with Bruises and
Well, you can call the office at 512-555-WHIP, or you can email me at iwilleatyoursoul@dominatrix.net, or you can follow me on Twitter, whipsinchains69.
Awesome. Is there anything else you'd like to say?
If you're interested in my services, but you're afraid to set up a session, you should be. I will f*** your up.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big thank you to Fantasia Black Soul from Bruises and I'm Bobby Ricky for TNN.
I think I knew her. She cured my lonely heart for $400.
Oh, then we might need to get her for the next staff party. Okay, and now we're going to catch our man on the street, Ferris, who's going to ask couples what they're doing on the worst day of the year. Ferry?
Thanks, Seamus. Hey, and just because we got drunk last night doesn't mean you get to call me Ferry in public. I'm here with Fred and Wilma Flintstone. Hey, guys. We're just wondering, what are you going to do for the most romantic day of the year?
Well, we met a couple of years ago, and every Valentine's Day, it's a tradition since we met jogging on Town Lake. You know, we love working out. We do everything together. We love working out. He loves working out with me. And every year, we go to the Congress Bridge and have a picnic, and then we work out afterwards.
Wow, that sounds extremely romantic. Now, let me ask you a question. How long have you been having sexual... Amanda?
Oh, did you see that? How tragic.
Aw, I wanted to see how long Fred and Wilma have been having sexual intercourse.
Well, after our next story, you can ask them yourself. And when you do, I would also like to know that.
Hello, TNN viewers. I'm Coach Mitchell here, standing outside the Memorial Hospital, where people have been coming in for days and days, sick with not the love bug, but the candy bug. That's right. Folks are getting sick from Valentine's Day candy. Now, we're really not sure what's going on. It's madness here at this hospital. In fact, I see a victim coming right here. Sir, can you tell me what's going on here?
Well, my girlfriend gave me one of those heart-shaped box of chocolates, you know, and I picked one up and it said, you will die a slow death. But I figured, you know, those things are never right.
Well, maybe there was a reason for the deception.
I don't know. It's really... hard to...
Well, the candy is fatal, apparently. And, excuse me, ma'am, can you please just tell me what's your case, what's happening to you with this candy? Can you tell me?
I actually didn't have a box of candy. I had a heart-shaped box of chocolates that my husband gave me, and it was really good until I looked in the bottom and it said the active ingredient was cyanide.
Cyanide.
Ma'am, we need to get her to the hospital now.
Well, there you have it, folks. Eat Valentine's Day candy and die. Coach Mitchell here.
Wow. I'm way too drunk to remember any of that story.
Still? So you also don't remember last night?
Not at all.
Well, in case you're wondering, I'm still sore. And now we're going to go back to Ferris for an update on his pathetic life.
Amanda, what the f***?
Don't cuss at me. You know I only like that in the bedroom.
We're engaged.
No, thank you.
But I love you.
Dylan, come on. Let's go.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Oh, walk it off, Fairy.
That's just too bad. I would care more, but I've lost all my emotions due to this hangover.
I too am hungover, and I just vomited. But not because of being drunk, but because of our next story, which is about Valentine's Day.
Ferris, get it together, come on.
The plight of Valentine's Day cards writers is quite the unromantic one. Face the reality of low-paying, monotonous, and just plain old boring job. It's a miracle that these writers can find it in them to be able to inspire the masses to have a lovely, romantic Valentine's Day.
My strategy for making nice cards depends on my dreams. I haven't had a real boyfriend since high school, so my dreams have been getting quite elaborate. I pull from my dream journal. You mean so much to me, and I want to stay in your arms forever. Happy Valentine's Day, my love.
It's a pathetic way of life for these people, and something should be done to help them out. I know how much I love getting a thoughtful card that someone bought for me because they were too uncreative or unattractive to write one themselves.
I graduated college with a degree in English. All my other English major friends managed to get jobs like editing books and assistant to Miranda Priestley. But I'm stuck here, writing Valentine's Day cards, getting paid less than a third of what I actually need to live on, like a Chinese shoes-making child. I can't even afford an apartment. I'm renting out a walk-in closet from a nice old lady for $100 a month. And in addition to the sexual favors, she only makes me vacuum the closet and her room once a day.
So if any of our viewers would like to donate funds to our local card printing company, please call the station for your donation. Please help these poor card writers begin a successful life on their own, outside of the closets of another's apartment. With TNN News, I'm Ferris Kirkendorf.
That was disgusting.
Well, what do you expect from a station that only hires prostitutes? Now let's check in on the train wreck that's Ferris's life. It looks as though he's having a bit of trouble finding a lover or two. Fair?
$50? You crazy! Why don't you just give me your body and we'll call it a sex show?
Ferris, who do you have there with you?
If I know. Hey, what's your name?
Imagination with a Y.
Imagination with a Y. And actually, she's about to suck my in the middle of the station while we both with a so happy Valentine's Day.
And now for our final story, something that no one cares about.
Hello, viewers. With the recent celebration of Valentine's Day this previous week, we here at TNN have put together a little list of V-Day do's and don'ts for you to keep in mind. We hope that all of you at home take these words to heart and implement them in exactly 359 days. Tip 1. Do talk about how much you love your significant other. Do not talk about the intricate evolution of the limbic system and neurophysiology and its pertinent role in the phenomena of fight or flight response. Tip 2. Do give your significant other a gift. Do not give your significant other a body image complex. Tip 3. Do take your significant other to the movies. Do not take your significant other to Justin Bieber Never Say Never unless your significant other is 12. Tip 4. Do send your significant other flowers. Do not send your significant other Gwyneth Paltrow's head in a box. And tip 5. Do cook your significant other their favorite meal. Do not cook your significant other. For TNN News, I'm Poppy Sanders.
And there you have it. That's all the news we have for today, and I'm gonna go help Ferris with that prostitute.
And now videotape it. Okay. I forgot what I was gonna say.
And now, a message from our sponsors.
Yes, exactly.
I'm into the camera this time?
No.
Okay. What the hell is this? I'm sorry.
That was a incorrect eyeline.
So do you have like a scrapbook of everything that's been printed?
Seven of them actually.
A scrapbook of everything that's been printed out?
Scrapbook? No. Oh my God, please don't. God, scrapbook, please. God, no. Me.
See, it's always good to start from the top.
Dígame, señor, ¿qué piensa de los Longhorns y el BTS bowl game este año?
There is no bowl game. We went 5-7. There's. What are we talking?
En español, por favor.
I don't speak
en
Spanish.
Español, por favor.
No hablo español.
Señor, no tiene nada que decir.
Estamos listos. Mira nomás la pasión pura que tienen los aficionados.
Hey. You got a light? Oh, yeah. Cool. Oh, can you hold this for me? Oh, yeah, sure.
Is brought to you by
from the people who brought you Sex, Soul in the Dust Bowl comes a whole new compilation for all you lovers out there. Not just any lovers though, long distance lovers. It's called Message in a Bottle. It has such wonderful hits as Wonderful Tonight via Skype by Eric Clapton.
It's late in the evening. She opens her MacBook Air. The blue as it pops up. She types in her password there. And then she calls me. On goes my little green light. And I say, darling, you look wonderful via Skype.
I call just to say I love you. Because that's the only way I can. By Stevie Wonder.
No airplanes, they cost a fortune. I checked the flights on orbit this afternoon. I just called to say I love you. And I mean it, though we are so far apart.
And my heart will go on Facebook chat. By Celine Dion.
I wait and wait some more. How long are you typing for? I try to ask, but it says my chat message was not sent because you're no longer on.
But that's not all. It has your other favorites from when phone sex isn't enough, like Your Body is a Wonderland, from what I can remember, by John Mayer. I'll Make Love to You in About 2 Months, from Boys to Men. Wouldn't It Be Nice If We Lived in the Same Zip Code, by the Beach Boys. And 1,000 Miles, literally, by Vanessa Carlton. So call in all you milephiles and get your copy of Message in a Bottle today!
In the latest edition of When I Grow Up, we have with us someone who I owe my early 20s and $19.95 to, Amanda Cunningstone. Miss Cunningstone is the CEO of the vibrator company Good Vibrations. Good Vibrations has turned into a huge success, Amanda, stretching the cavities of women everywhere. How did you come up with such a wonderful product for the female species?
It started with this idea I had over Valentine's weekend 4 years ago. I was wondering why some dateless women aren't having a lot of fun on that day. And then it hit me that most women don't have the right vibrating equipment to get them through the day. So I invented Good Vibrations.
And boy, am I glad you did. Let me tell you, my mornings have gotten so much better, I don't even need my coffee anymore. Now, tell me about the new lines of vibrators you have coming up for women.
Well, the company's creative department has come up with some really cool things. We're debuting our new vibrator this fall called Vanilla Lush. It spurts out a bit of vanilla right as you're finishing.
Well, I know that I will enjoy that, definitely. But how does your family feel about your profession? Are they happy with what you're doing?
Well, my sisters are. And my mother.
Oh, you're so bad.
Yes, but no, seriously, my family fully supports me in my career choices. They've always been there for me. I have a sister who is a professional slut coach, so needless to say, I'm a favorite at the family reunions.
You're also a favorite around the office, with all the ladies and with Philip McCrevis.
Oh yes, he was our biggest order last year.
And the little devil didn't even share.
Well, that doesn't matter, because I have a surprise for the news team.
Really?
Everyone's getting a vibrator!
Oh yeah! Excellent!
You get a vibrator, and you get a vibrator!
I know that will make everyone so happy, especially me, because I've nearly worn my old one out. Let's just say, I've racked up a few frequent vibrator miles.
That just lets me know that I'm making one hell of a product.
And on that note, this has been Jacqueline Crumpet for TNN.
Hello, viewers. It's Poppy Sanders here with Cupid, the god of hot love. Mr. Cupid.
Coop. Call me Coop.
Coop. You shoot people with arrows, causing them to fall in love. What's your game, sir?
Well, basically, I'm trying to kill them. If you want to call that a game, then go ahead.
You mean you aren't trying to unite lovers? You're trying to kill them?
You got it, Toots.
Why?
Hell, I don't know. The family biz, I guess. See, my old man Mars, well, he was the god of war. He was never around growing up. Always off pillaging and murdering. I guess I just wanted to impress him. What better way to impress the god of war than to be a deadly assassin, am I right? But turns out I got aim.
Then how the reputation for being a matchmaker?
It's embarrassing. But I was out one night trying to take out some guy. Long story short, I wounded him. He ended up falling in love with his nurse, and they went around saying that it was my arrow that brought them together.
Aww.
All of a sudden, it was cool to get shot by Cupid's arrow. Of course, that just pissed my dad off, but he's an
So you're still out trying to kill people?
Do you have any idea how hard it is to kill someone with an arrow? Like, impossible. So now instead of killing them, I just try to heavily inconvenience them.
And how do you do that?
I dip my arrow in herpes.
Oh, wow. Well, there you have it, Austin. Cupid is a menace and should be avoided at all costs. I went digging and it got dirty, but I found the truth. Signing off for TNN, this is Poppy Dirty Sanchez Sanders.
Got what you need.
Hey, join, wait, what's the name of this show?
Capital
Cineforum. Join Capital Cineforum. Come over here. Yeah, yeah, you.
Capital Cineforum.
Yeah, exactly.
Anybody interested? Capital Cineforum?
Hey, you.
Hey.
You and the Chuck Norris, yeah.
Yeah.
Capital Cineforum.
Capital Cineforum.
What's Capital Cineforum?
What's Capital Cineforum?
Yo, we're Capital Cineforum on TSTV, and we sure don't bore them. If you're a UT student of film, and you made a short film, well, listen up. Our office is a staff for one big tool to showcase your shorts that are really cool. Just go to the website and grab the paperwork, then take it and the short to the HSM clerk. TSTV, the place to be, they call us Capital Cineforum with a capital C. We ain't short, but we put them on the TV screen.
Log on to facebook.com/CapitalCineforum.
Yo, 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 that was Capital Cineforum right there.
Check it out, dog.
The Sneak Peek would like to take a moment and ponder the trends of tomorrow.
Comic book musicals.
3D cooking.
for TNN News, I'm Sacagawea Johnson, reporting from Canada about the new hockey phenomenon where bad words and fighting is no longer allowed. I'm here with Sidney Coffin, a player in the league. With the new no curse, no fighting policy, how are the players adjusting?
Well, first of all, hey, Sacagawea, it's not good. It's hard. It's hard not to curse, not to fight, but it's okay. We figured our way around it.
Really? You just don't say bad words in all the words?
No more bad words. Hey. Mm.
So what do you say for
Well, we say kumquat.
What about
carrot?
What about
Well, let me put it this way. We replaced every curse word, eh, with a vegetable or a fruit, eh? It's really that easy.
Let me try this. My gooseberry sucking, cabbage swilling, ex-wife Barbara. That sounds fun.
That's really good, eh? You feel good? You feel good?
Oh yeah, real good. But how do you guys get rid of all that physical fighting?
All the fighting? That's even easier, eh? Check this out. Hey. Hey, Montel.
Oh, yeah, you say it.
Me and your sister, eh?
Oh,
had a good time, eh?
Oh, sure, yeah. You strawberry sucking little fruit.
Strawberry sucking little fruit, eh?
Yes.
You want to sell this, eh?
Okay.
Say it. Mercy.
No.
Say it.
No.
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 Mercy.
Mercy.
You kumquat sucking shallot.
You pineapple eating.
No. You strawberry
assortment of fruitcake.
No, it's over.
Well, for TNA News, this is Sacagawea Johnson.
Welcome to TNN Debate Corner, where we discuss the issues that people care about, like panda bears or homophobic giraffes. I'm Sacagawea Johnson, and this week we try to decipher the reason for the season and ponder if Black History Month and Valentine's Day are really compatible in the same month. With us, we have Valentine's Day enthusiast, Dr. Candice.
You can just call me Candy, like the candy hearts.
Okay, Candy. And we also have our resident Black person, George Washington Carver.
Actually, it's Bruce.
Okay. Now, tell me, Candy, why is Valentine's Day so much better than Black History Month?
Well, Valentine's Day is like a day where people can share their feelings and stuff. My boyfriend told me that he loved me to make me his and it was really cute.
That is so romantic. That is not something that could happen on February 15th, no, is it, Bruce?
People can say that any day of the year. It doesn't take a few boxes of chocolate to tell someone you love them. Black History Month is a time for African Americans to learn about their culture. That isn't taught in schools.
In my history class last semester, I learned that Slim Thug was, how do you say, African American. So yeah.
To be fair, Bruce, can't the same thing be learned during Hispanic Appreciation Week or the more recent Appreciation Week call for the Fruit Loops mascot, Toucan Sam?
Actually, no. Toucan Sam can't tell you that Rosa Parks didn't move from her seat on the bus because she felt victimized against just because of her race.
I think she was just lazy. Candy, can you tell me some of the benefits of Valentine's Day?
Valentine's Day is amazing. I like it.
What a good point. That's just beautiful.
She didn't even say anything.
Don't get high and mighty just because she's not like you. You have no right to victimize her in such a way.
Seriously, yeah, like, don't.
What has become of this world?
It's like warming or something, like, you know, the globe.
You're so smart, Candy. You must have done so well in high school.
So
she
well.
Hasn't said anything of importance this entire debate.
Now, Bruce, I have had it with your high and mighty attitude.
So have I.
I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
Are you serious?
You're making me call security guards Kyle, Kevin, and Chris with a K to escort you out of the field.
This is ridiculous. I'm leaving.
And that's all we have for TNN's debate. Once again, I'm Sacagawea Johnson.
Cool.
So, Madeline, should I take my pants off now?
Yeah, sure, whatever. Who are you again?
Sorry, what? I'm sorry. What?
No, not her.
I'm sorry.
I look at the phone.
Hold on, guys.
Excuse us. Excuse us.
She still calls sometimes.
I mean, really?
These people are problems. Behind Sneak Peek would like to take a moment and ponder the trends of tomorrow.
Tween fanaticism over mummies, the breakout of swing hip-hop fusion, the rise and fall of the historical sci-fi genre, TV's debut of Celebrity Driver's Ed. Sneak Peek, an entertainment news show that may just be ahead of its time. For the most hip and hot updates, tune in Thursdays at 9:30.
On your dorm channel 15.
Cable channel 16.
And on your antenna channel 29.